I'm back in at the old Josephine Iron Mine, a very old location, and maybe another 5 years, this site will be 100 years old. I found this piece of crudely smelted iron here, and we'll have a closer look at that. What a nice piece this is. Here on the one side, we can see pieces of the actual crushed rock that was melted in when they smelted this. Had to be here on site, it's very crudely done. But a great souvenir, a piece of mineral from this site. Awesome. I'm here at the top of the hill overlooking the old Josephine Mine. Here's one of the buildings that's completely collapsed. The roof is in. As you can see, it's located right here on the lake shore. This lake here in front of me was completely drained. Back in the day, it was being mined to help prevent flooding. Here we're looking down on, I'm not sure what that is, but built on a very heavy platform is this round slab of cement, approximately 8 inches thick. I have no idea what that was for, unless it was a base to a smelter or something to that effect. Let's pan to the right here. We can see all the broken down equipment, rusted steel. Quite an interesting location with a lot of mining history here. I've located a few nice samples of the iron ore from underground. They must have dumped some of the ore here on the edge of this hillside. We'll have a closer look at this. Here's two nice examples here. Here's one here with the typical red oxide, and here we can see the iron in it, and the red banding could possibly be a chert or a jasper. Here's a piece here, it's totally grayish black in color, very high specific gravity. There's a lot of iron in that one, very nice. Fortunately, this time I was able to get my vehicle right to the site. Last time I had to stop due to overgrown brush. This time I tried something new. I shrink wrapped around my vehicle to prevent it from scratching, and it worked great. So this is good. I'll be able to take some samples out. Possibly have some of these cut with a diamond saw. Should make nice pieces.